Okay guys, so in this video I will talk about the splice, okay, about column splice or beam splice, whatever it is. And before starting, if you are new to this channel, please do subscribe because it really matters a lot for me. Okay, so let's start. First, what is actually splice is? Splice means nothing but a joint. Okay, let's say you are trying to construct a long beam, okay, but the material or the member which do you have are short. So what do you have to do? You have to make a joint. Okay, this is member 1 and this is member 2, and you are making a joint. Okay, and when you are making this joint by some arrangement, steel arrangement, that is known as splice. Okay, so in this figure here you can see this is a picture of pipe rack. And here you can see that the bottom part, okay, so this bottom part has been constructed at site, okay, and this whole top portion, okay, in white color, this portion has been transported from your shop and it has been put over this red column, okay, here. And simply at site, what you have done some bolt arrangement, okay, you have tightened some bolt and your structure is ready. So in this case you can say that you have made some splice joint over here, over here, over here, 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 and so on. Okay, clear? So basically you can say that a splice joint is nothing but a joint, okay, which connect simply two member. Here this is member 1, this is member 2, okay, so that's it. And second, if you look at the detailing of the splice, you can see that, well, this is number 1 member, okay, and it has ended here, okay, it has ended here, and this is member 2. Okay, so to connect these two member 1 and member 2, what you need to do, you need to simply apply some arrangement that is nothing but bolt and plate. Okay, so you have got some basic idea about splice. Now come one by one parts. Okay, so first thing, here you can see that this is a yellow plate, this is a yellow plate, and this is also a yellow plate, and this is a 3D picture. Okay, 3D modeling. If you look from this side, okay, from this front side, so what you can see, you can see a plate in the middle, this is in yellow color. Okay, here this plate represent this one, and let use some different color. Here is another plate, okay, which plate here? Of course this one, this plate. Okay, so we have typically two type of plate. Here you can see, okay, a blue one and a red one. Okay, now why blue one and why red one? Let's try to understand. Okay, basically these two picture are nothing but same. Here we have applied this plate at the outer face of the column and here in the inner face of the column. Okay, so let's try to understand why these two type of plates are required, why this blue plate is not sufficient, or why this red plate is not sufficient. Okay, so first, what are the name of this part? This part, yes, you are correct, this is known as wave of any I section. And what is the name of this part or this part? Yes, these are known as flanges. Okay, so now tell me, if you have watched my videos, my previous videos, you should be able to answer this one. Okay, so tell me, in any I section, let's say this is the I section, okay, what is the function of this flange and what is the function of this web? You should be able to answer it. Well, the function of this wave is to carry, yes, shear force, okay, and the function to carry the function of this flanges is to carry the tension or compression coming due to bending. Agree? No confusion? So that is the reason here we have also used two different plate. First one is here you can see this blue one. Okay, the function of this blue plate is to connect the flanges of the column. Okay, and here also you can see that it has been attached to the flanges. This is the flange, this is the flange, and also this is the flange. These plates are connected with the flanges. So they are basically used for transferring the tension or compression from one column to another. Don't worry, I will discuss how a tension or compression is coming. And second one, this wave is transferring the shear. So in number one, let's use the red one for wave. Okay, so in column number one, let's say there is some shear force. You have to transfer this shear force to this bottom one. So what you have to do, you have to simply connect their wave by this plate, this red color plate. Got it? So you have understood why this flange plate and this wave plate are used. Okay, in any splice, whether it is a column splice or a beam splice, it doesn't matter. Okay, here you can see that this guy is actually trying to construct a beam splice. Okay, now I have kept this picture to ask you certain question. Okay, so now tell me what he is actually basically doing. Yes, he is trying to connect the waves. Okay, he is trying to connect the waves by this plate. He has already put the plate in place. Now he is simply putting this bolt, and later he will simply tighten it. Okay, so he is now simply trying to connect the waves. Here you can see that flanges are now, I'm marking it in blue color, the flanges are now not yet connected. Here you can see also the top one. Okay, they are not yet connected. Okay, so the basic concept is clear. Why the splice is required? What are the different function of different component of a splice? Okay, now come to the mechanism. Okay, so let's say after here this is a column splice. Here you can see that flanges has been connected. Okay, here you can see that flanges has been connected. This is column 1, this is column 2, the flanges has been connected, but the wave is not connected yet. Here you can see the wave is not connected yet. This is the gap. Okay, this is the gap you can see. So let's say we have a compressive force coming to this column. Okay, so simply if this is a column and if this is another column resting, this column 1 is resting over column 2. Okay, and there is a very little gap. Now you are simply applying, let's say, a compressive load. This is the support. So this is the compressive load you are applying over column 1. So what will happen? Simply this column 1 will transfer this compressive load to column number 2. Okay, through bearing action. Okay, if you have properly connected all these two columns, this compressive load will be transferred to column 2 via bearing action. No issue. So why do we need a splice? Okay, let's try to visualize again. Let's say we have another set of column, this one column 1, and let's say we have column 2 drawn in green color. and it is this is the support. Now what happened? You are applying some moment. So what will happen here about this point, this column 1 marked in red color, try to topple like this. Why this happens? Because you have not jointed them. There is no joint. Okay. So this was one problem. Also consider another cases. Let's say we have another set of column. Let's say this is column 1 and this is column number 2. Okay. This is column 2. Sorry. This is column 1 and this is column 2. Okay. Now what happened? You are applying some shear force at column 1. What will happen? Simply column 1 will move to its new place. Why? Because you have not jointed them. So for this reason, you need to join them. Okay, so again go back for transferring the shear force. Okay, for transferring the shear force, what you need to do? You need to connect them at the wave. Okay, and also to transfer the bending moment, here you can see, let's say we have a bending moment like this. So, you know that I always convert any bending moment into a push and a pull. So, here this is the pull or tension and this is the push or the compression. This is the tension. So, here you can see that this flange, or let me use some another color. This flange is actually under the action of tensile force due to this bending moment. So, to transfer this tensile force, this is tension, to transfer this tensile force to this column, what you have to do? You have to put some bolt first. Okay, through this bolt, it will go to this column. Okay, then, sorry, from to this plate, then from this plate to this bolt. And then from this bolt to this flange of the column 2. Got it? This was column 1. Okay. So try to visualize the force flow. First you have applied the moment here. It has been converted into tension here. This tension has transferred to this bolt from this flange. Then from bolt to this plate. Again from plate to bolt and bolt to flange of the column number 2. Similarly, if you try to visualize the force flow of the shear force, so first you have applied shear force in column wave, then it has transferred to this bolt, then from this bolt to this plate, then from plate to this bolt, and again from bolt to column wave. As simple as that. This is the basic mechanism of your any splice, whether it is a column splice or a beam splice, it doesn't matter. Okay, and finally you have designed your column splice or your beam splice with your bending moment input and your shear force input, and the output are, what are your output? First you have designed the number of bolt required with certain diameter and the thickness and dimension, better I should say, the dimension of the plate, connecting plate. Plate for flange, plate for wave. That's it.